Hello guys, hi, and thanks for tuning in to my YouTube channel. I'm your girl Malda Memes, and today I'll be telling you guys why you have to come and work in Qatar this 2020. Things are getting better here, and that's why I urge you, if you're outside there and you've been like thinking you want to come here in Qatar, this is the right time to come. Ask me why. Okay, I'll tell you why. Why? Because we have a new rules and legislation that was rolled in by the Qatar government, and these new rules are like we have an advantage of it. And the first new rule is that this is the end of kafala system. I've written it down so that I don't give you the wrong things. I don't want to communicate something wrongly. So the end of kafala system. This is the system that allowed the Qatar nationalism to employ other people from outside, from other nations. So, and that meant that your sponsor had every right and every power over you. But with this new system, that's the end of it. Like, your sponsor don't have any right over you as much as your sponsor, but yes, you can change your job. That's another rule that was passed on, and that's a big one, because I've stayed here for 1 year and it was hard to change job. As much as if you had another job, it was hard, but with this year new rule is that you can change your sponsorship, you can change your job without an NOC. That's something to celebrate about. So what's an NOC? The NOC is a certificate that you needed to change your job. If you found another job somewhere, you could just move to any job or jump to any job as much as it had a better pay. You had one certificate, you had to have that. And with this new role in 2020, you don't need that to change your job. And that's a good thing. That's really a good thing. So I've stated two things, and that was the new legislation, the end of kafala system, and you don't need an NOC. And another thing, another good thing is a non-discriminatory minimum wage. This means that regardless of your color, your race, your nationality, you'll be paid equal. You'll be paid equal. Like if the baristas will be paid equal. Philippine baristas, Indian baristas, Kenyan baristas, if waitresses, the same thing. And this is a good thing because something of us, many things, oh, I almost fell out. A lot of these things have been affecting how people are getting paid here in Qatar. But if we have an end of these, this will be great, like, but this has not been passed. It will be later passed in the year because they have to find out the rates and all so that they can come up and agree and give out the new wages that the workers will be paid here. And another thing, there will be no exit permits. When you're here working in Qatar, you know what I mean by there will be no exit permits. Because if you had to leave Qatar, you had to have an exit permit, and that would come from your sponsors. And if they don't want you to leave, they will deny you the exit permit. But now, if you want to leave this place temporary or permanent, you don't need any exit permit at the airport. You just leave. So I've mentioned three, and those are the most important things, I think. That should tell you why you should come to work in Qatar. And about the jobs available here, we have a lot of jobs here, so don't slakey, use slakey. That's our language in Kenya, use slakey. Come and get your job here, because we have all sorts of jobs. We have nursing job, we have barista job, we have waitress, we have cleaners, we have nannies, we have security. There's a lot of jobs, so you can't lack a job here. And so I think I've made myself clear, and I think I've given you the information that you all needed, why you should come to work in Qatar 2020. And all this is because of the new rules and legislation that was passed on this year. And I repeat again, but on a quick, don't mind don't mind my nails. I didn't have time to do them. So I repeat again, over and over again. But for the last time, the first one is the end of kafala system, whereby your employer had all the power over you, and that's over by now. And the second one, the non-NOC, you don't need an NOC to exchange your job. If you have a better job or somewhere better, a better pay, you just exchange your job. If you see like your cleaner and your founder job in barista, you don't need an NOC, you just change it. And another one is the non-discriminatory minimum wage, but that hasn't been passed right now. It will be sorted out later in the year. And the third one is the no exit permit. And I guess those are quite nice rules. And they favor everybody working in Qatar from outside. And that's it for now. And on my next video, I'll be telling you 10 things that you need to know before coming to work in Qatar. As for now, like this video, subscribe, and give it a thumbs up, and put on that notification bell. Thank you. Stay tuned. Bye. Lots of love.